Okay. My name is Colleen Chigodo from Zimbabwe. I'm the EPI officer, expanded program on immunization officer for the country. My presentation is going to focus on the investigation report which I carried out on a laboratory confirmed measles case in Hurungwe District, Doro Clinic area, Gangaragwe area in Zimbabwe in Mashonaland and West Province in the village called Nziramasanga Village. Introduction. Investigation was carried out in Hurungwe District, Doro catchment area, following confirmation of a lab measles case, which was positive. This case was identified under Doro Clinic, which is about 56 kilometers from the district hospital of Hurungwe in the western direction. Then the lab confirmed case was 20 kilometers in the same direction. The community of Doro catchment area derives its income from tobacco and maize farming. Their Christianity, their religion is Christianity. The area has got some hard to reach families by distance and by religion. By this, I mean that some villages are inaccessible for immunization services because of distance, and some are inaccessible because of religion. They object to vaccination. So that's the population breakdown for the Doro Clinic. It has got a total population of 6,936, and the under 1 year old children are 238, and the under 5 year children are 1,106. The aim of the investigation was to conduct a detailed investigation following a confirmed measles IgM positive case in Doro catchment area of Hurungwe district. The last outbreak of measles in Zimbabwe occurred in 2010, where there were about 500 cases. And this one is the first of its kind since 2010. Objectives of surveillance of investigations were to carry out active search in the community of the confirmed case of measles through the village health workers. The village health workers are the frontline health workers within villages who identify cases and refer them to health facilities. The village health workers are the second one was also to conduct interviews with the Doro Clinic staff to assess their knowledge and skills on vaccinations. Then monitor surveillance activities at the clinic. And also the last one was to assess cold chain management at Doro Clinic. Cold chain management has got a bearing on the management of vaccines, because if a child is not given potent vaccine, it means that the child can suffer from measles. But if the vaccine is kept under good cold chain system, then the child is given potent vaccine. And then after being given a potent vaccine, the child is not likely to suffer from measles. These are the highlights of activities. The team visited the clinic and assessed their knowledge and skills in routine expanded program on immunization and expanded program on immunization disease surveillance. We checked the T12. These are the registers, the T series registers, and the integrated management of childhood illness register, and they were conducting active search as indicated by documentation of active search in the register. This is an example of an integrated management neonatal and childhood illness register, which is there at the clinic, which they document all the children which are treated at the clinic. So in this document, it's not clear, they were indicating that they were documenting that they are carrying out active search, and it was documented in red. And also expanded monitoring immunization graphs and case definition were displayed on the walls. The case definitions aid the health staff to identify cases of measles using those case definition, and the EPI monitoring graphs shows their performance on vaccination, measles vaccination, whether they are reaching a target of 95% and above. Because if it is the coverage is below 95%, it shows that the herd immunity is most likely also to be lower than 95%. Then coverage for both 2016 and 2017 was displayed, and it was above 100% as indicated by the T6 and T5. These are the monitoring forms where they tally the cases, they tally the coverage. After vaccinating a child, they tally on what is called a T6 form. Each child is tallied on T6 form. Then after being tallied on T6 form, something has appeared on my presentation. Okay, thank you. Then they summarize on the T5 form. And then they also put the summary on the monitoring chart to show their performance. So this is an example of a monitoring graph at the clinic, which was shown there. As you can see, that's the performance of the measles. Measles rubella 1 and measles rubella 2 there. And this is the target. That is 100% and that is 95%. They were actually, by the time we visited the clinic, it was somewhere there in July. Into the July, August, the target was almost above 100%. They have reached the target. They also displayed measles case definition charts on the walls. These case definitions aid the staff to identify a suspect cases of measles for investigation. Then at the clinic, they had adequate stocks of all antigens, that is vaccines, and had not experienced any stock outs in the past 6 months. This indicated that all the children which were coming to the clinic received the vaccines. We also conducted interview of health staff, and they were quite knowledgeable on the expanded program on immunization program, including expanded program on immunization disease surveillance and effective vaccine management, which keeps the vaccine potent. Staff members at Dodoro Clinic work as a team, and the same knowledge was across both members. They were all knowledgeable on management of vaccines and management of measles cases. The clinic staff had also carried a home visit to where the measles case reside. We screened all schools around, that is Gangaragwe, Nyamfukuza primary schools, which was nearby the clinic, and used village health workers to carry out active search in the community. By using village health workers, they were carrying what is called community-based surveillance, whereby the village health workers, which were trained in the community, were moving around within the community trying to search for more cases of measles. The facility identified 2 more cases, and results were not received at the time of investigation, and no more cases were identified up to time of report writing. It means that these cases which were identified, other than the first lab confirmed, these were suspect cases, and blood was collected for virology, and they were waiting for results to confirm whether they were measles cases or were not measles cases. Intensified social mobilization was done through dialogue with local leaders. Within the catchment area of that clinic, there were leaders, the community heads, the community leaders, the headmen of the villages, the health center committee members within the village. They were given health education on the lay case definition of measles and how to identify those cases within the measles and what they are supposed to do after they identify the case. Then the district team, we are now moving to the district team, what was done by the district team within that district. They supported the health facility, they carried out active search again, visited the homestead of the case, and also visited Kachingamire village, where Miss Petros and a baby, which is the case, had visited prior to the illness. The family, the mother and the child, visited a certain village other than their home area before they came to the area, before the child suffered from the illness. So the district team visited that area. They sensitized the people there who were gathered. It was about plus or minus 50 people who were gathered celebrating Independence Day. So they gave those people health education on measles and Laker's definition of measles, and they also encouraged them to send their children to clinic for vaccination if they are not vaccinated against measles. A total of 123 children were screened for EPI diseases at that celebrating center. These were gathered at Karesha Business Center, where the mother and child had visited. The investigation team, that is us now, visited. This was the third team. We're trying to confirm what has been done by the Royal Health Centre, the clinic staff, the district health team staff, and we were coming from national level, accompanied by the provincial team from that province. We visited Kangaragwe School, which is 12 kilometers from Doro Clinic. From that is the school which is nearby where the case resides. The school has an enrollment of more than 400 children. On the date of visit, the teacher also confirmed that no case of measles was seen at the clinic and at the school. We proceeded to the homestead of the case, which is in Tiramasaka village, which is 5 kilometers from school and 15 kilometers from the clinic. We conducted interview of the grandparents and the mother of the case, as indicated by the fig below. So that's the picture of interviewers of the national team. Myself, I'm wearing a floral dress, and this is the provincial EPI officer from the province. We're accompanied again by the district nursing officer from that district. And this is another district nursing officer from another district who wanted to learn on how we are supposed to carry out an investigation. And with the team, that's the grandparents of the grandparent of the child. And that's the mother of the case, and this is the case who suffered from measles. Both grandparents and mother could greatly articulate how the child got ill. They were all knowledgeable about measles community case definition. They were so much surprised with the child having been diagnosed of measles because they believed that measles had been eliminated because of vaccination. We reviewed the child health card, and child was up to date with vaccinations. He received two valid doses of measles at 9 months and at 18 months. The child was malnourished and was on Plumbinat. This is food for the malnourished children, which was being given from the health center. Fig 5 is the measles case. The measles case is the one in a pink top. This is their homestead. And this is the grandmother and the other brothers who are nearby at the same, who are seated by within the village. And this is a plate of groundnuts. It's a very poor family. The grandmother referred to a homestead. When we are carrying now further investigation, the grandmother referred to a homestead which is about 500 meters from their homestead, as the family from the True Apostolic sect, which were vaccination objectors and had children which were not vaccinated. The team wanted to visit the homestead, but we were barred from doing so, as they felt it would create friction with the family. However, they advised the team to give the test to the local village health worker. The team then, me being part of the team, we proceeded to the to visit the village health worker, Ms. Mberi Kwenyanga, living in the same area. We interviewed the village health worker, who said she carried out active search in the community and did not find any suspected measles case in a catchment area. We passed through village health Bukuta in the same area, who directed the team to the village health worker in the next village, Kachingamire village. We interviewed the village health worker, and he was knowledgeable on measles community case definition. He also confirmed that no cases of clinical measles were identified before and after the index case. And he said he was continuing with community-based active search in the area. Then these are the recommendations which we discussed with the clinic, with the district level, and with the provincial level as a team. These are the recommendations for the community. The village health worker, Mberi Kwazo, was supposed to visit the Piri family, that is the vaccination objectors family, to actively search for clinical measles case and refer. There was also need for the community to make continued information giving at gatherings and homesteads by community leaders and community-based health workers, which are the village health workers. Then the village health workers to continue community-based active search. Then recommendations for the health facility staff, they had to continue informing, giving information giving to the community They are supposed to they were supposed to continue supporting the health center, the health facility in giving health education to that catchment area community. And they're also supposed to support the health facility. The health facility support was supposed to continue active search for more cases. And there was also supposed to be continued monitoring of the index case, especially nutrition-wise, since the child was malnourished. And the health facility staff was also supposed to conduct head count of children below 1 year and under five, so that they know that when they are vaccinating children, they've got the actually physical head count of the children. Since at times the physical head count of children differs with the statistical head count within the health information system, so that they are able to follow up their children by number within each village to assess that there is no more cases, there are no more cases of measles. They will also need to indicate population by village, by hard to reach, on the reaching every child map. By reaching every child map, we mean that this is a village, this is a map which shows villages, number of children by villages, children under five by village, children under one by village, and distance from the health center by village. And this aids the health workers to map up strategies on how to reach the hard to reach population, how to reach the vaccination objectors population. So this is what is called the REC, which means reaching every child map. Then these are recommendations for the district level. They need to continue to support the lower level facilities, continue to mobilize and distribute resources and logistics to the facility. This includes vaccines, maintaining the cold chain system by servicing the refrigerator at that health facility so that it maintains the correct temperatures for the vaccines.